everyone. Thanks for joining me on this video. It is all about this page that I made recently. We're going to start off with a piece of letterpress paper, and it's pretty thick. It's definitely different than cardstock, and it has little fibers in it. And then I'm just going to spray some Delusions spray mist, spray ink on it, and also some of this Ranger Adirondack spray ink as well. And blot it off with the paper towel, and you'll be able to see how the fibers in this type of paper soak up the inks differently and everything, and especially right now while it's wet, you can really see it. As the ink dries, it will definitely fade and soak in more to the paper since it's so thick. Now I want my colors to blend a little bit more than they are. Some of the lines are sharp on there between the blues and the greens, so I'm just going to add a few squirts of water on it just to help it out there, and then I'll blot it again. And a little more water. Okay, so let's dry that. I'm going to use a heat gun just to give it a good drying through, but it's going to take actually a little longer than that to get it to dry to the core. But at least it won't be running and getting all over my hands while I work. Okay, so that's good to go. And now I'm just going to tone down the color a little bit. I'm using just white acrylic paint and some water, making it kind of milky. And then I'm just going to spread that all over my paper just to tone it down a little bit, fade it, make it not so harsh. Okay. And that pink mat that I'm using is a craft mat, so I'm able to get it hot with a heat gun, or just wipe paint right off of it. It's really handy to have. And Tattered Angels is the manufacturer of this one, but there's also some great ones by Basil and Ranger as well. And now I have out my Epic 6 and these new dies by Lifestyle Crafts called Details Dies. These are the doilies. And I'm going to put the flat side down on my platform, and then the pretty side of my paper down on top of that, and then this mat on top of it, and you can see it's pretty well used. And then I'm just going to run it through my machine. So I feed it in and crank it through. And the cool thing with these details dies is that it embosses and cuts out at the same time. So if you have any problems getting it out, you can use one of these quick stick pens, because it has a little point on it and a little spatula part, and then also the sticky part where you can pick up your pieces if you have little tiny ones and place them where you need them to go. So it's really cool to use as well, and that's also a Lifestyle Crafts product. Okay, so I have three of those cut out, and let me see if I can show you this detail on there. Get it in the right light. That's kind of hard with the ink still being a little wet too. Gives it a little hard to see. But we'll let those dry, and I'll cut out some more of them. So I'm just going to place them back on there, flat side down, and then pretty side of the paper facing those, and my mat back on it, and then I'll just crank it the opposite way right through. And then pop them right out. Okay. So now here's my art journal page, and I have this piece of book text to put down, and I like to use matte medium, and I put it in this little tube, that way I can just have more control over where I put it. Not that that matters so much, but it just makes it a little easier. So I'm just going to adhere that to my page and wipe up any spills. I always seem to glue my book together. And smooth it out with a brayer. And then I'm just going to put a little bit more matte medium around the edges so it doesn't peel off. I do want my books to have a little bit of longevity to them. Okay. So I want to put a little bit of that watered down white acrylic paint over this just to tone down the yellowness of this old book page. So I'm just going to do like I did before, spread it all over it. I'm not covering every bit of it, but just to tone it down a little bit. And then I'm going to let that dry. And also figure out where I'm going to stick these. Now, I had accidentally stuck these all down and then realized that I want to do something else with them. So I chopped out that part of the video, and I'll show you what I ended up doing instead in just a second. Oh, and I used the gel medium this time instead of the matte medium because it's a little thicker. It's more like paste, so it holds it on there better. So I ended up ripping all those puppies right off after I got them kind of placed. They weren't exactly where I wanted them, but pretty much. So very cool, just going with the flow here, ripping up my paper a little bit more, you know, gives it a little bit more character and dimension, so I'm not worried about it. That's the fun thing. So I'm just going to peel that away a little bit. And then add a little bit more of the white paint on it to, you know, kind of smooth out different parts. And, you know, it also helps it to not continue to peel. Okay. So just let that dry. And since I'm impatient, I'm going to give it a head start with that heat gun. And then I remembered that since these dies are embossed, that I can use an ink pad just skimming right across the top of it, and that will pick up the raised parts of the embossing. So let me just slow it down to show you. So I'm just gently smoothing it on there, and you know, it's not going to be perfect, but it will give it a lot more dimension to it, and you'll be able to see those raised parts a whole lot better. So this ink, this is the first time I've used this particular one. I really like it. It is by Colorbox, and it's the Donna Salazar Mixed Media ink in Indigo. So pretty cool. And here's my quote. It says, "To commit mistakes is not wrong. Commit as many mistakes as possible, because that is the way you'll be learning more. But don't commit the same mistake again and again, because that just makes you stupid." So I saw that quote online, and I really liked it. So that's the quote I'm going to use on here. But first, I'm going to make all of these doilies into flowers. So I am using one of my favorite pens. It is the Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pens. And these are great because they are made out of India ink. So once it dries, it is archival, it's waterproof, it's permanent, lightfast. It's just a great pen to use for this sort of thing. Because I'm going to be using water and other, you know, juicy things on this page, I don't want to smear black around. So I'm just going to doodle these all out. I'm going to limit my commentary right now while I do that, and then jump in a little bit later. Okay, now I brought out some of my Stamper's big brush pens as well. And these are also India ink, also made by Faber-Castell. And so they have all those great qualities as well. And the fun thing is when this ink is wet, you're able to spread it out. So I'm using a wet paintbrush that's just wet with water to just pull the color around. And so it's more kind of like a watercolor at this point. And then again, once it dries, it will be, you know, archival and waterproof and permanent and light fast and awesome. So I can use it, you know, as a kind of a watercolor with the paintbrush, or I can go just color it directly like I would any other marker. So I'm just going to continue filling in this page. Some of it's going to be watercolored, some of it's going to be just direct, and I'm just going to get that done. For the finishing touches on the lettering part of this, I'm using this kind of light gray color to just add some shadowing under each of the rectangles of words. And then I'm just going to add a little bit of sketching, again with that Pitt artist pen. So using the pen to sketch around there sounded like a great idea until I realized my glue wasn't completely dry and so it was clogging up my pen. And then I liked it, but it wasn't quite bold enough. So I am taking my big brush pen in the black and just outlining it with that, giving it a little bit more of a pop. Okay, so that's my finished page and how it looks in a still shot. And I want to remind you once again that if you really love these Lifestyle Crafts products, that you can go to their website, lifestylecrafts.com, and enter coupon code Erin for 20% off your entire order. That's sale items, everything. So go check that out and stop by my blog, erinbassett.com, and say hi and let me know if you have any questions about anything or other techniques that you want to learn. Shoot me an email or, you know, leave a comment on my blog. Okay, that's it. Thanks.